Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to teach you three useful things for the beginners in pipetting, how to get the formula for takeoff, or how to get takeoff by using formula, and piping installation, and piping layout, and simple offset. Now we go back to the how to get takeoff. So in order to get the takeoff of the 90 degrees elbow, supposed to be this is 6 inches in diameter. So 6 inches by 90 degrees elbow long radius butt weld. So we are talking about takeoff. The takeoff is came from the center of the fittings, from the end side of the fittings. So here's the formula. So the formula is 38.1 multiplied by size of elbow. So the result is take off in millimeter. So I want to clear you guys, 38.1 is the constant formula. So but where we get this 38.1? So we'll go back to that. The other way is 1.5 times 6 inches. 1.5 is constant formula also. So 6 inches is size of elbow. So the takeoff in inches, that's the result. Now we are talking about where we get this 38.1. Where we got this. So simply 1.5 came from here is multiplied by 25.4 is 38.1 the result, because if you are using the 1.5 formula and multiply by the size of the elbow, you will get only the result in inches. You need to convert it in millimeter, because we all know that the dimensions in the isometric is all in millimeters. So why you are using this 1.5 where you can use 38.1 direct result is in millimeter. So I'll repeat guys, 38.1 multiply by size of elbows. Any size of elbow 6 inches, so the result is 228.6 millimeter. So from here to here, the dimensions is 228.6 millimeter. Now we go to 45 degrees. So 45 degrees elbows, the same method, from the center of the elbow to the end side the elbow. So the same size 6 inches supposed to be by 45 degrees elbow butt weld. So here is the formula, takeoff formula for 45 degrees. So there are two things formula you can use, 15.8 or 15.9 multiply by any side of elbow. That is the result of takeoff in millimeters. So why I use 15.9? Because for me, based on my experience, 15.9 is nearly precise for computation for taking takeoff of this 45 degrees. Why? Okay, I will explain you. So in order, there's that one thing, this is related guys. I will first explain this. 0.625, this is constant formula also, multiply by 6 size of 45 degrees, the result is 3.75 inches. So 3.75 inches 3.75 inches Sorry, I forgot to put the point decimal. Times 25.4 is equal to 95.25. So by using this method in inches, we get we got 95.25. Take off. Okay, this is the explanation why. If you multiply the 6.25, that is in inches, and you convert it to millimeter times 25.4, the result is 15.875. So this is the formula, exact formula for getting takeoff in millimeter. Not so, it is in the middle, 15.8 and 15.9, as I said before. So, but if you round off it, 15.875, it will near to 15.9. It will become 15.9 if you round off. So, to be exact, if you compute this 15.875 times 6 is 95.25, the same as the result here. In inches, you convert it to millimeter. So, to avoid confusion, guys, you can use 15.8 or 15.9 because it's a little bit difference only. Instead of using 15.875, you can directly use 15.8 or 15.9. Cannot affect the what this spool you cut because it's a very very small difference. Okay, we go back to a piping installation. So this is the, if you go to site, this is side view. You can encounter this installation. Supposed to be 6 inches pipe diameter. So you need to get this full in order to install that pipe. So supposed to be the dimension is 1500, because in the isometric plan, guys, the all dimensions came from the center of the pipe. So 1500, that's an example, but the center to the center of the fitting's elbow. So example 1500, yeah, minus take off the elbows. Okay, we simplify it by like this: 1500 minus 228.6, because we got this 228.6 by we compute this 228.6 by using formula 38.1 times 6. So the result is 228.6, but you need to minus these two elbows. So I make it simply like this: 228.6 times 2. Simplify this, just multiply this 228.6 times 2. So whatever the result, you can minus to 1500. So the result is 1042.8. So that is the spool. But keep in mind, guys, that if you fit up the fittings and the pipe, you need to put gap 3 mm. It is necessary because that is the preparation for the root pass. And of course, the alignment. So like this, by using this, you can fit you already compute the spool, you can readily cut this. You can minus if you want the two gaps. Yeah, the two gaps in the 3mm gap, 3mm gap, 6mm gap. 1042.8 minus 6mm. So you can cut precisely this pool. Here is the little bit difference, guys, because in here the one side is 90 degrees, the other side is 45 degrees. So the same method by using formula for getting the takeoff of this 90 degrees and 45 degrees and minus whatever the dimensions here, you can also get the spool. Okay, this is what we call simple offset. So this is simple offset. There's another formula. I make it clear, guys. I make it the details here. So from here, this is the simple offset. Okay, I enlarge it here. In the simple offset, you need to get the travel. The travel is came from the center of that 245 degrees. So, and the set is the came from the center of the two pipes. So here's the formula, guys. Formula for simple offset: set multiply by 1.414. That is constant formula, guys. So the result is travel. So you can simply compute this by your mobile calculator, in your calculator in your mobile or any calculator. No need scientific calculator. So I hope this is clear for you guys. I explain it very well to you. So no problem, don't worry. I will pin this images at the end of this video. And to continue update my videos, please subscribe my channel and hit the notification button to update my new videos, useful videos especially for the beginners, pipe fitter beginners. So this is a big help for you guys. So in my next videos, I'll explain to you guys how to read the isometric plan. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching my channel. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.